Getting a set of aftermarket wheels for your car can be one of the most satisfying and rewarding modifications you can do. A new set of wheels can completely change the overall look and appearance of your car, and it can be one of the defining factors that really just kind of ties your whole build together. The good news is that there are thousands upon thousands of different wheels to choose from when it comes down to picking out a new set. And there is a lot to, you know, like, take into consideration with this process. You have things like price, you got color, you got size, you got style, you want a lip, you want concave, you want monoblock, you want multi-piece. And the list just goes on and on. But have you ever thought about weight? Has the weight of your wheels ever crossed your mind? Is it something that you've ever taken into consideration when looking for a new set of wheels? And more importantly, is it maybe something that you should if you haven't been already? What is going on, everyone? Gels from Fitment Industries, and today we are gonna be diving into a topic that just gets the old, like, scientific gears turning in everyone's brains and talking whether or not wheel weight actually makes a difference when it comes to power and performance on today's episode of Myth or Fact. Before we go ahead and get right into the nitty gritty of today's episode, please subscribe. It helps us out a ton. It takes less than a second. And for those who did, you know, thank you very much. You got put on, like, the nice list for now and just in time for Christmas, so you lucked out there. Also, don't forget to go ahead and pick up some of the new apparel that we just dropped in partnership with BC Racing, so you can get your chance to win a free set of BC Racing coils, either from the BR or DS series line of coilovers. Time is running out pretty quick here, so don't miss your chance to win. And of course, get some dope apparel like this hoodie right here. Other than that, you already know, wheels, tires, and suspension, fitmentindustries.com. Anyway, it should be no surprise that saving weight when possible is an extremely important thing when it comes to performance cars and racing. Developers, drivers, and racing teams take extreme measures to save as much weight as possible in certain types of racing, meaning they are stripping any unnecessary interior bits, covers, plastic, seats, trim pieces, you name it, which does make actually a pretty astonishing difference when you actually look into it. So in a shocking turn of events, we're gonna get the answer, like, right out in the open, right away here, and say yes, wheel weight does matter, and it can make a difference, actually a pretty good difference. The question I guess we're left with is, you know, why? And how much of a difference can it really make? First thing we need to understand, though, is the different types of manufacturing for aftermarket wheels. So as many wheel manufacturers, companies, factories, designs, and manufacturing processes out there right now in the world of aftermarket wheels today, wheel weights are just, like, all over the board. And a lot of times, it's pretty hard to find what the actual weight of a wheel is before buying it, just because a lot of, you know, companies don't list it. Maybe you might get lucky and find someone on a forum who has the exact wheel in the size that you're looking at and has weighed it themselves, but chances are pretty small and you'll probably just end up searching for quite a while before you find that answer. If the weight of your wheels is important to you, an easy way to start narrowing down your options is to know the different types of manufacturing processes that are used to manufacture your aftermarket wheels. First and foremost, you have cast wheels, probably the most common and most popular. These are made by pouring molten aluminum into a mold to form an entire shape of the wheel. Once cooled, they are sent to finishing to get cleaned up, painted, and have the bolt pattern drilled, and they're on their happy little way. It is currently the most inexpensive way to manufacture wheels, which means that they are usually always the more inexpensive option when it comes to aftermarket wheels on the market. The next step up from cast wheels would be what we call rotary forged wheels, or flow form wheels, or whatever name the company is branded. This is when the face of the wheel is cast into a mold just like the casting process, but it is then taken to a forging machine to literally press out and draw out the barrel of the wheel, essentially forging that barrel. By doing this, there isn't as much material needed to make the wheel, so it keeps weight down. At the same time, by aligning that molecular grain structure of the aluminum in the barrel by forging it, it is allowed to be thinner due to the higher strength to weight ratio. So overall, just not as much aluminum being used. Next up will be monoblock forged. Now, forged wheels are typically the lightest option out of the group. However, they also typically are the most expensive as well. These wheels usually start out as a forged blank and are either stamped and then cut by a CNC machine or just straight up cut by a CNC by a CNC machine to its final shape. And then lastly, there are multi-piece wheels, another version of a forged wheel. Even though the faces of the wheels are still forged, they aren't typically, you know, the lightest of the group. With the addition of hardware and them usually being pretty large wheels, the weight starts to add up. Depending on the overall design and process used to manufacture the wheel, it's pretty clear to see why weights can really start to vary all over the place. One of the biggest impacts and the biggest reasons as to why the weight of your wheels can make a difference is because of a little thing called unsprung weight. When looking at a vehicle specifically, you have both sprung and unsprung weight. Sprung weight is basically everything that is supported by the vehicle's suspension, some things like the chassis, the interior, the engine, transmission, etc. Unsprung weight, on the other hand, includes everything else that isn't carried by the suspension, which would be, of course, the suspension itself, things like brakes, wheels, and the tires. The general rule of thumb is that for performance application, you want to have the least amount of unsprung weight as possible. Having a lighter unsprung weight with help from a lighter wheel will allow more control and grip of the vehicle, because with a lighter weight on the unsprung side of things, things are able to react more quickly. They're able to adapt to the road better. There's less mass to move all around. The other main ingredient here is rotational mass or rotational inertia. In simple terms, how much energy is needed to get something rotating up to speed. With a heavier wheel, more energy is needed, especially from a standstill, to get it moving. And of course, the exact opposite with a lighter wheel. Now, something important here that I want you guys to take away from this is that heavier wheels will not decrease the amount of horsepower of your car. That's not really the thing. And lighter wheels, on the other hand, will not increase your horsepower. What it will change, however, is how much of that horsepower is actually useful and transferred to the ground. Wheel weight is something that we should all care about, at least a little bit, as car enthusiasts. We see more and more companies every day start to move into either the forged or rotary forged market, and in some cases, moving away from their cast wheel lineup entirely. It seems that in recent years, it has almost been a little forgotten about, but it is finally making a comeback. And that's really, you know, like toot our own horn here or anything a little bit, but even with our own wheel brand that we just launched, Artisa Wheels, we took wheel weight into a huge consideration when developing them. All them starting off right around 19.1 or 19.2 pounds per wheel, with the largest size of 19 by 11 only hitting 22.9 pounds, which we're damn proud of, all right? So we're gonna talk about it, and that's the sales plug. But other than that, let us know down in the comments below if wheel weight matters to you, and if so, why does it? Other than that, don't forget to check out Wheels, Tires, and Suspension over at fitmentindustries.com, and let us know what you guys would like us to cover on the next episode of Myth or Fact. I'm Gels from Fitment Industries. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you later. Peace.